Good morning, students. We can start our social science class, History, Chapter 5, The Vedic Age. Already we have studied in the previous class about the Vedic Age, how the Aryans came and how they started the Vedic Age and how the Veda city is divided and the epics and all we have seen in the previous class. And today we can study about the social life of the Aryans, how the life of the people, the Aryans, they were living and the society was, this all we can study today. And first we can see the village in Vedic age. The Aryans lived in villages or the gramas. These consisted of a number of a thatched hut surrounded by a fence. And the Aryans, they were living in the villages or the gramas and they are having the huts. It is like surrounded by a fence. And as the tribes gave up their nomadic way of life and took to agriculture, villages became bigger. And when they started to do the agriculture, the villages hit very big. The people of the tribe were known as the Janas. Big tribes were divided into clans and a group of dilated families were known as a clan. And the people of the tribe, they were known as Janas, and the tribe, they were divided into clans. Also the group of the families, the related families, they were known as the clan. The family or kula was the smallest unit of the village. From the village, the family, it is family or the kula, it is the smallest unit of that village. And the family of the Aryans were patriarchal, that is, the head of the family used to be a senior male member, generally a grandfather, who enjoyed respect and took all the decisions, and other members of the family obeyed him. And from that family, the head of the family, it will be a male or the grandfather, and others all, they are obeying him. And what are the decisions the head of that family or the grandfather he is taking, all others are obeying him. And next we can see the administration. The Aryans were divided into many tribes and each tribe used to live in different region. The Aryans, they were divided many tribes and each tribe, they are living in the different regions. And the tribal chief was called Rajan. The tribal chief is called Rajan and he led his tribe in war and maintained law and order. He also offered prayers and on behalf of the tribe. And he received a Bali voluntary donation for his services. The Rajan was assisted by officials such as the commander-in-chief, the chief priest and the village headman. The Rajan consulted his subjects on important matters. He did this through a sabha or the small committee of selected village elders, and the samiti, it is a general assembly. The samiti chose the Rajan. And here the administration, it is saying about the Aryan, they divided into many tribes and the each tribe, they are living in each region, and the tribal chief is called the Rajan and he is leading the tribe and maintaining the laws and order. And he offered the prayers also, and he received the voluntary donation for his service. And this is saying about the administration. Next we can see the Varna system. The Varna system, the society was divided into a basic of Varna or the skin color, and the society, they divided into the basic of Varna. And the fair skin Aryans considered the dark skin Dasas inferior. And the fair skin, they are considering the dark skin, they are as a Dasas inferior. And the Dasas were the original inhabitants of the region where the Aryans settled. And we can see here the four sections of the society, they were divided, the Varna society is divided, the four sections of the society: Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. And the Brahmins, they are the priests who is looking after the religious matters and they recited the prayers. The Brahmins are the priests. They are looking after the religious matters and they are reciting the prayers. And second, the Kshatriya, they are the king and the warriors, and they are who protected the tribe from harm. The king and the warriors, they are protecting the tribe from the harm. They are the Kshatriya. And the third group or the third society is the Vaishya. They are the farmers and the craftsmen. And the last one, they are the Shudra. They are those who work for others. They are working for others. And those Aryans who disobeyed social rules were considered Shudras. And those who are not obeying the rules of the Aryans, they are considered as the Shudras. And these are people, those who work for others, or they are the slaves. And these are the Varna societies divided: the Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. And as we can see, the system of social division based on occupation later developed into the caste system. And it started with the occupations. They are divided, then it is developed into the caste system. The Aryan's family was headed by males. Male ancestors were also worshipped, and kingship became hereditary. Women were considered inferior and were not treated well and not allowed to attend public meetings. And here the Aryan family, it was headed by the males, and the women, they were considered inferior and they are not treated well and they are not attending the public meetings and all. An Aryan's life was divided into four stages during this Vedic period. And during this Vedic period, the Aryan's life, they divided into four stages. First one, Brahmacharya. Second, Grihasthya. And Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. These are the four stages the Aryan's life, it is divided. And this is the Varna system. The Varna, it is divided, or the society was, it is divided for the Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. And the Aryan's life, it is divided into four stages: the Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. And you can see the next occupations. One of the most important occupations was agriculture. The most important occupation, it is the agriculture, and they grew wheat, barley and millet. Hunting and cattle breeding also remained important occupation, and the mainly it is the important occupation is the agriculture, and they are growing the wheat, barley and the millet, and hunting and cattle breeding also it is the important occupation. And what all things they hunted? They hunted wild buffaloes, bears and other animals for their meat and skin. For their meat and skin, they are hunting the animals, the wild buffalo and the bears and the other animals also they are making for the meat and skin. And bulls were used for ploughing and drawing carts. And the bulls they were using for the ploughing and all. And the cows were reared as they provided milk. And from the cows they are getting the milk. Wealthy and rich family was assessed by the number of the cows it want. And the wealthy family, they are having the number of cows. And cows were given also as fines for the misdeeds. Aryans also used the horses which had been brought from Iran and Central Asia. The horses was mainly used as a means of transport. They were used for riding and drawing chariots. Chariot racing used to be their favorite pastime, and ownership of chariots was a status symbol in the society. The Rigveda mentions that there were artisans and the craftsmen such as carpenter, potter, chariot maker, weaver, etc. And here the already we have seen the occupation, what all the occupations they are doing. And the people, they were having the horses also. The horses, the Aryans, they took from the Iran and the Central Asia. And they were using these horses mainly for the transport. And they were used the riding and the drawing chariots. And this all they were using. And the occupation, it is saying, they were doing the agriculture and the hunting and the cattle breeding. Then next we can see the food, dress and amusement. The Aryans ate simple food like wheat, barley, vegetables, fruits and meat. The Aryans, they are eating the food like wheat, barley, vegetables, fruits and meat. But the cow was not killed for food, and the cow, it is not killing for the food. They drank a great deal of milk and used plenty of ghee. And from the cow they are getting the milk and they are using the plenty of ghee. Their dress consisted of mainly two pieces of cloth, the upper and the lower covering. And their dresses, they are using mainly two pieces. One is for the upper and the lower coverings. And the turbans also were used. The turbans means what they are covering, or in the head what they are covering, that is the turbans. And that also using. And both men and women used ornaments. Ornaments were made of beads, gold, silver and other metals. And the both men and women, they are using the ornaments. And the amusements of the Aryans were chariot racing, hunting, gambling, horse racing, dancing and playing musical instruments. For music, they used flute, veena and drum. And they were using for the amusement, they were using the Aryans, they were using the chariot racing and hunting and the gambling and the horse riding, dancing and all. And from here we have seen about the Aryans' food and dress and the amusement. And next we can see the religion. The early Vedic gods Indra, Varuna and Agni lost their importance. They were replaced by Prajapati or the Brahma, the creator, Vishnu, the perceiver, and Shiva, the destroyer. And the religion, about the religion, it is saying the early Vedic gods was the Indra, Varuna and the Agni was, they are the importance, but they were replaced into the Prajapati or the Brahma, and he is the creator, and the Vishnu and the Shiva. And Hinduism as it exists today began to take shape in this period. In this period, the Hinduism what it is existing now, it is begun to take shape. And sacrifice amused great importance, and religious worship became very complex. And this time the religion also it is started. And we can see the next, we can see the education. The girls received education at home. A boy spent his student time in a gurugul, where the guru or the teacher lived with his family and the pupils. The people served the guru in return for the knowledge gained. And the education, it is saying the girls, they are receiving the education at the home itself. But the boys, what they are doing? The boys, they are spending his student's life in the gurugul. Gurugul means, guru means the teacher, and the gurugul where the teacher's family and the pupils, the students, those who are living in one place, that is the gurugul. And the boy, they are going to gurugul and they are getting the education. And knowledge was passed on orally in Sanskrit. They are getting the knowledge orally in Sanskrit, and most of this knowledge was from Vedic literature. All the knowledge they are getting from the Vedic literature. And grammar, astronomy, medicines, the art of warfare, music and the architecture were also taught. And this all it is taught by the guru. That is the education it is saying. Next we can see the Chalcolithic culture. Discovery of the first metal, copper, brought a new era in man's life. Already in previous chapter when we studied about the Harappan civilization, we told that there we discovered the bronze metal, and here the first metal, the copper, it is brought new era in man's life. And the people learned to use copper, tin, bronze and iron. Then the people, they were using the copper, tin, bronze and the iron. In North India, people switched to copper from stones from making axes, spear, heads and other objects. And this period after the Neolithic age, when copper was used along with tiny stones implements, it's turned as Chalcolithic age. And when they were using with the copper and the tiny stones implements and all, it is turned the Chalcolithic age. And in India, there was no Bronze Age as such. The The use of bronze ware started in the Copper Age, so we generally call this intermediate age the Copper and Bronze Age. And the use of iron started much later, which marked the beginning of Iron Age in India. And the Chalcolithic Age, mainly it is saying that about the copper, when they discovered the copper, it is made the people, the new era in the man's life, it brought the new era. And they were developing many tools and all. And we can see the futures of Chalcolithic Age. The Chalcolithic culture in India traditionally included non-urban and non-Harappan culture, which made their first appearance around 2000 BC and were eventually replaced by iron-using culture. The Chalcolithic people built the rectangular and the circular houses of mud mostly in clusters, and they were not acquainted with burnt bricks. Fire worship seems to have been a very widespread phenomenon among the Chalcolithic people, as fire altars have been found at a number of Chalcolithic sites. And we can see here about the Chalcolithic, the features of the Chalcolithic age. The Chalcolithic people, they were building the rectangular and the circular houses of mud mostly in cluster, and the fire altars have found at this at a number of the Chalcolithic site. Many fire altars they found this time. And next we can see the megalithic burials. The megalithic is a grave or a memorial for dead people. The megalithic, it is a burial or the memorial for the dead people. Those who died, for them it is, they are making the memorial. This is the, it is called the megalithic. And the word megalithic comes from two Greek words. Mega means it big, and lithos meaning stones. And the megalithic therefore means big or large stone. Then the mega, it is a big, and the lithos, it is the stone. So it is known as the large stone. Many tribes of Indian have built various megalithic architecture since Neolithic and Chalcolithic age. In the Neolithic and the Chalcolithic age, they made many megalithic architecture. And the megalithic were burials in the graveyards away from the area where people lived. And where the people they were living from, there it is that place the burials they were keeping, the megalithic burials, where it is far from the people they were living. The megalithics have various shapes and forms. These different tribes for dead people according to their hierarchy or importance, or to show different causes of death. And we can see here the many megalithic burials have been found around the Nagpur, Maharashtra, and the Maski, Karnataka, and Naganchukonda in Andhra Pradesh, and the Adichanallur in Tamil Nadu and Kerala. These places we can see the megalithic burials. And the megalithic burials show a variety of methods for a disposal of the dead bodies. And the megalithic burials, mainly it is showing that the variety of methods they are using for the dead bodies, the disposal of the dead bodies. And in some cases, the bones of the dead were collected in large urns and buried in the pit. And sometimes what they are doing, they are collecting the bones of the dead bodies and they are burying in the pit. And this pit was marked a circle made of stones. And this pit, how they are marking? They are making with the stone, circle of stones, they are marking this pit. And another kind of megalithic burials found is a grave with rows and of stones in a diagonal and the square pattern. And another type they are making, they are keeping the dead bodies there, and they are making the, with the stones, they are making the rows of stones, they are making the square pattern and all. This is the megalithic burial. We can see they are burying there, and they are making the big or the large stone, and they are keeping the large stones there. That is the megalithic burials. And from this chapter, And we can see the case study. It is a Inamcon. It is saying about the Chalcolithic site. Just you can read and understand. And from this chapter, we have studied about the Vedic age, how the Aryans they came and how they were living, how the life of the Aryans and how they were their villages they started and their administration and their occupations and the food and the dresses they were wearing. This all we have seen, and mainly we have seen the life of the Aryans in this chapter.